Microphones pick up sound from a particular direction, which is called a polar pattern. In live sound, the ones we use most are cardioid and supercardioid, but there are a few others that you'll see, and we'll cover those in a bit. But cardioid is the most common. This works kind of like you'd think a mic does. The sound in front of the mic is picked up normally, and sound from behind the mic is cut. And if you move to the side, it'll still pick up some sound, just a little bit less than right in front. But if you have a supercardioid, it picks up from the front, but it also picks up a small amount from behind. And if you move to the side, the sound is cut a lot. We call this a tighter pattern because the mic doesn't pick up as wide of an area. The best example for these is the difference between a Shure SM58 and a Shure Beta 58. The SM is cardioid and the Beta is supercardioid. I mean, they do have slightly different sonic characteristics, but the polar pattern is worth thinking about when choosing which one to use. I like this example because these are so common to see at live music venues. And just knowing the shape of a polar pattern will help you choose the right mic for the job, but there are a couple situations where this really makes a difference. First is with wedges. Sometimes you need to get the wedges really loud. Some loud music just requires this. And as we all know, if you're turning up a microphone really loud, you can also get feedback. And even though the main way we control feedback is with EQ, you should think about the polar pattern of the mic and the position of the wedges as well. If you're only using one wedge, you might have extra feedback problems with a supercardioid. Using two wedges will let you spread them out and create a dead zone behind the mic. But using a cardioid with a single wedge makes it a little easier to keep the feedback under control at loud volumes. Now, this is not a hard and fast rule. In fact, many things about live sound are not set in stone, but it just helps to think about the concepts and know how the gear is interacting. Now, a tighter pattern will also help reduce some of the ambient stage noise. When I have a really quiet singer, it means I have to set the gain higher on the console. This not only boosts the singer, but it also boosts the rest of the noise from stage. This usually doesn't sound very good, so it's something to try to keep under control. All right, let's talk briefly about the other polar patterns you'll see. In addition to cardioid and supercardioid, we also have hypercardioid. So this is very similar to supercardioid, so you can think of these two as acting pretty much the same. But we also have omnidirectional, which we just call omni. This picks up sound equally from all sides, which isn't very useful for live sound. Not only will it pick up almost every other noise on stage, it will also pick up the sound from the wedges and main speakers. Now, this would be terrible for feedback. The only situation I've seen omni used for in live sound is for clip-on lavalier mics, like this one I'm talking through right now. These are great for presenters, but not very good for live music. And finally, we have bidirectional. Ribbon mics are bidirectional by design, and that's kind of the only time you'll see a bidirectional polar pattern in live sound. They'll pick up sound from the front and back, but not the sides. So if you do use them on stage, you can use a baffle to help keep unwanted sound from getting in the back of the mic. And microphones aren't always fixed to one pattern. Some condensers can be switched between polar patterns, like the AKG 414 we saw in the last video. This can actually change to 5 different patterns, which is great for the studio, but for live, we usually just stick with cardioid or supercardioid. And even though some microphones are designed for specific instruments, there are no absolute rules for what sounds good on what. When you experiment with dynamics, condensers, ribbons, and polar patterns, it helps develop your personal preference in microphone choice.